In this example, we'll use the graphing calculator to find the vertex, y-intercept or vertical intercept, and x-intercepts or horizontal intercepts of a quadratic function. In the previous video, we did this by hand. So the first step is to enter the function into the calculator. So we'll press y equals, clear any old functions by pressing clear, enter the new quadratic function. So we have 2x squared minus 14x plus 7. Let's start with a standard window. To make sure we have the standard window, we can press zoom 6 for the standard window. But notice how we need to adjust the window now so that we can see the vertex. So we'll have to decrease the y minimum. We can also get rid of this piece of the graph by increasing the x minimum. So we'll press the window key. Let's increase the x minimum to, let's say, negative 2. We'll press enter until we reach the y minimum. Let's decrease this to negative 20. If this doesn't work, we can always come back and change these values again. So go ahead and press graph. Notice how this is a pretty good window. Here's the vertex, here are the two horizontal intercepts or x-intercepts, and here's the vertical intercept or y-intercept. Notice how because the parabola opens up, we would find a minimum function value at the vertex. If the parabola opened down, we would have a maximum function value with the vertex. But because our parabola opens up, in order to find the vertex, we'll press second trace and select option 3 for a minimum. Again, if the parabola opened down, we would select 4 for maximum. So we'll press 3. It's asking us for the left and right bound. So for the left bound, we want to be to the left of the vertex, so we'll arrow over to the left. Anywhere over here is fine. We'll press enter. Arrow over to the right when it says right bound. Maybe somewhere here. Press enter. When it says guess, we can just press enter again or move the cursor closer to the vertex. Press enter. We need to recognize here the calculator is not perfect. The coordinates would be 3.5, comma, negative 17.5. We can also express these as fractions. Let me show how you can convert these decimals to fractions on the calculator. So if we go to the home screen by pressing second mode, we can type in 3.5, press math. Notice how the fraction option is already selected. So we'll press enter twice, enter, enter. It converts 3.5 to the improper fraction of 7/2. And then for negative 17.5, we can do the same. Negative 17.5, math, enter, enter, and it gives us the improper fraction. So these coordinates are equivalent to 7/2, comma, negative 35/2. Either of these two forms are acceptable. Now we want to find the y-intercept or vertical intercept. So if we go back to the graph, we can see that the y-intercept is here. We just can't tell the coordinates. But remember, any point on the y-axis would have an x-coordinate of 0. So we can find this point by pressing second trace, and then select option 1 for value, enter in the x value of 0, and then press enter. So when x is 0, y is 7, which would be the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the point 0 comma 7. Of course, we could also just find f of 0. If we sub 0 for x, notice how the function value would be 7. And now we'll find the x-intercepts or horizontal intercepts. Notice how we have one here on the left and one here on the right. We can only find one at a time. So we'll press second trace, and then the x-intercepts are where the function value is 0, so we use the 0 feature to find the x-intercepts. So we select option 2, and let's find this x-intercept first. It's asking for the left bound. Notice in this case, if we're left of the x-intercept, we would be above the x-intercept where we are now. If we want, we can get closer, maybe somewhere in here. Press enter. The right bound would be, in this case, below the x-intercept, maybe somewhere in here. Enter. And again, when it says guess, we can just press enter again. It says rounded two decimal places. So the x coordinate would be approximately 0.54. So we'll say the first x intercept or horizontal intercept is the point 0.54, 0. And now we'll find the second x intercept. We'll repeat the process. We'll press second trace option 2 for 0. The left bound of this x-intercept would be below it, somewhere over here. Let's move the cursor over there. I went a little bit too far. Let me come back. Now the cursor is to the left of this x-intercept, so we'll press enter. To the right in this case should be above this x-intercept. Maybe somewhere in here. Enter. And then enter one more time. And again, notice how the calculator is not perfect. We need to recognize this value here as 1 times 10 raised to the power of negative 12, which is very close to 0, which is what the calculator means. So the second x-intercept would have an x-coordinate of approximately 6.46. So our second x-intercept would be 6.46, 0. Before we go, let's take a look at this graph again. Here's the graph of our quadratic function. Here's the vertex that we found. Notice how because the parabola opens up, the y-coordinate or the function value would actually be an absolute minimum because it's the smallest function value of this entire function. We have two x-intercepts, one here and one here. And we have one y-intercept here at positive 7 on the y-axis. I hope you found this helpful.